losing the vegetarian food culture and justifying it. No, no, even in Vedic times, people used to have non-veg. It's the worst stupidity. It is like a disowning all the modern day scientific discoveries and living a stupid life and then blaming, no, no, no. Even in those days, people used to be like this. Just like modern day, great research, development, contribution by the modern day scientists in the field of technology, many outer world sciences, our lifestyle, thought current, everything is the technology revealed by the great rishis after thousands of years of study, research, development as inner world science in the inner world. Listen, purely ironed out, non-violence, non-stealing, minimalist, integrated, pure life, taught by Krishna to Arjuna, Upanishadic rishis to us, understand. That is extremely strengthening technology, powerful technology. Listen carefully. You become Hindu when you discover the cosmic, powerful cognitions of Upanishads, not just because who your father and mother is. You don't become Hindu just by being born to father, mother who are legally Hindus. You become Hindu when you discover the powerful cognitions of Upanishads, Brahma Sutra, Bhagavad Gita, Veda Agamas. This pure love, tyaga, non-violence, all this will look as if weakening, loser, loser's thought current. No. If you do tyaga, withdrawing, not involving, not fighting, all that due to wrong cognition, you will become weak. If the fear is the reason, consequences, your thought current about the consequences, you think about the consequence and you don't have confidence about the future consequences and you stop acting, making decisions, progress, move, then you are weak, you are chandala. If you act based on reactionary assumptions, violence, again you are shudra, panjama, chandala. If your core beliefs are extreme love, powerfulness, tyaga, consciousness, it manifests as a power beyond your body.